Jinni and Cuckoo.
Hi there. Welcome back to JinnikuTV, where we make animation fun, easy, and totally beginner friendly. If you're new here, we are so excited to have you join us. And if you have been following our Adobe Animate series, welcome back. Today, we are diving into the essential part of Adobe Animate, that is, understanding the timeline and layers. This video is part of our Adobe Animate's beginner series, so stick around to set the perfect foundation for your animations. The basics of timeline. Alright, let's kick off with timeline, the heart of your animation. If you have worked with any video editing tool, the timeline might look familiar. This is where you decide when and how things happen in your animation, giving you full control over the flow and the timing of your animation. Each row on the timeline represents a layer, which helps you organize different elements of your project. While we will deep dive into the layers in just a moment, let's first focus on the timeline itself. The timeline is divided into frames, which act like a snapshots in a flipbook. The more frames you have, the smoother your animation will look. And here's something important to keep in mind. The frame rate, or FPS, that is frames per second, determines the speed of your animation. For a deeper understanding, you can check out our dedicated frames per second FPS video in this series. By default, Adobe Animate sets the frame rate to 24 FPS, which is a great starting point for most animations. Working with layers. Now let's discuss layers. In animation, layers are incredibly useful tools that help you keep your project organized. Whether it's a character, background, or text, layers ensure that different elements stay separate and don't interfere with each other. Imagine you're working on a sandwich. You have got bread, lettuce, cheese, and maybe some mayo. Layers in Animate works just like that. Each ingredient has its own space and you can arrange them how you like. Here's how you work with layers. First, let's see how to add a new layer. Just click the Add New Layer button on the timeline panel. You can also add a new layer by selecting an existing layer, right-clicking, and choosing Insert Layer. Adding a new folder. To organize your layers, you can add a folder by clicking on the Add Folder button in the timeline panel. Name the folder and drag the layers into it to keep your project tidy. Renaming layers. Double-click the layer name, type something meaningful like the character or background and hit Enter. Locking layers. If you're done with a layer and don't want to accidentally mess it up, click the little padlock icon next to it. This will lock that layer. Hiding layers. Use the eye icon to hide the layer you don't want to see right now. This is super handy when you're focusing on one specific part of your animation. Here's a pro tip. Always keep your layers organized. Rename them and lock unused layers to avoid accidental edits. Creating and managing layers for animation. Now that we know the basics, let's create some layers and see them in action. For this example, we will animate a bouncing ball. Start by creating a new project in Adobe Animate. Add a layer for the ball and name that layer Ball. Add another layer for the background and name it Background. Draw a simple ball on the ball layer using the oval tool. Convert the ball to a symbol. Remember, motion and classic tween works only if the object is converted to symbol. On the background layer, draw a simple line to represent the ground. Now we will use the timeline to create some motion. Let's say we want the ball to bounce in 2 seconds. With a project frame rate of 30 FPS, that's 60 frames. Click on the frame 60 of the ball layer and hit the keyboard shortcut F5 to extend the timeline. Now, using the knowledge from the previous videos, you can create a bouncing animation by either using classic tween or motion tween. If you haven't watched those videos yet, we recommend you watch them first. For now, you can carefully observe how I create this animation. For this example, we will use motion tween. You can further add ease in and ease out to enhance the animation. And there you have it, a quick dive into understanding the timeline and layers in Adobe Animate. By organizing your elements with layers and using the timeline effectively, you are one step closer to mastering animation. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like this video, share it with your fellow animation enthusiasts, and subscribe to JinnikuTV for more tips and tutorials. And don't forget to hit that notification bell to stay updated. Until next time, keep creating and have fun with your animation. Bye for now. Happy animating!